In this video, we'll try and understand how to read the consolidated profit and loss statement of a company. The profit and loss statement, or simply the P&L statement, is a representation of how much revenue the company recognized for the given year, given financial year, what was the expenses during that year, what was the amount of tax that the company had to pay, and finally, what was the profit that the company took home for that given financial year. A typical P&L starts with reporting the revenue recognized for the year. This is also called the top line of the company. So in case of Bajaj Auto, we can see that the company recognized close to about 27,000 crores in terms of revenue from sales to the customers, right? Then we can also see that Bajaj Auto has reported other income. Other income is usually revenue derived from non-operating activities of a company. It could be a dividend income, it could be a interest income, or anything that is non-core to the company. When you read the top line of a company, and there's usually something called as an associated note, right? For example, we can see note number 21 associated to revenue from operations. What this means is when you go to that particular note number, you will get more details about what that particular line item is trying to showcase. Let me go to note number 21, which is associated to revenue from operations, to understand this better. So here is note 21 associated to revenue from operations. We can see more details here about the nature of that particular line item. We can see that there is how much revenue was generated via sale of products, how much revenue was generated from sale of scraps, how much revenue was recognized via royalty, and other different elements that really make up the line item. So all you need to remember is that the top line of a company is simply the summation of revenue from operations, other income. So these two put together forms the top line of the company. So once you're through with the top line of the company, the next focus item is the expenses part of the company. The expenses part of a company is where the company reports different expenses that it has incurred for the given financial year. This can include the raw material cost if it is a manufacturing company. It can include the salaries paid to employees. It can include things like depreciation amortization. It can include interest payments on the debt it has taken up, and all the other expenses such as paying for electricity, paying for rent, paying for power, paying for advertisements if it has carried out any. So all these expenses are bunched under the expenses section of the P&L. So we've got the revenue of a company. We've also got the expenses of a company. If you simply subtract the expenses from the revenue of a company, you get the operating profit of the company. After accommodating for all the expenses, you get the operating profits of a company. Now, with the operating profits, you deduct for all the taxes that has to be paid for the given financial year. And you, after paying for taxes, what you're left with is the final profits for the company, also called profit after tax, or the PAT. The profit after tax is also called the bottom line of the company. So let me quickly summarize the profit and loss statement of Bajaj Auto for you. As we can see, Bajaj Auto has made 27,000 crores from operations. It has recognized close to about 1,200 crores from other income, making the total top line to 29,000 crores. Bajaj Auto has also incurred an expense of 23,000 crores. We can also see that Bajaj Auto has roughly about 1,300 odd crores in terms of taxes to be paid for the year. So income minus expense minus taxes will give us the final profitability of the company. And as we can see, the profit for the year is 4,857 crores, which is the bottom line of the company. So one mistake that most investors do is that they look at just the bottom line of the company. They just pay attention to the PAT of the company and ignore the rest of the P&L. I would suggest you don't do that, because the top line and the expenses is as important as the bottom line of the company. Pay equal attention to all parts of the P&L. Another important thing that you need to bear in mind while looking at the profit and loss statement is the associated notes. In fact, this is very important across all three statements, that is the P&L, balance sheet, and cash flow. The associated notes is where all the details of that particular line item lies. So the line item is really the summary of the notes. So please pay attention to the note and try and understand the nature of that particular revenue or the expense part of the P&L. So now that we've learned how to read and understand the profit and loss statement, we'll now focus on the balance sheet of the company, and we'll do just that in the next video. Key takeaways from this video are: